Howdy, everybody. Courtney Rowland here with Mark Passwaters out at the Spring of Football Game 2019. Danny and Mark already came to you after the first half. I want to talk mostly just about spring, what the expectations were and where they met.
I think so. The big issue for me was replacing players that were lost, especially on the defensive front. I think we saw tonight that they've got a good bunch, regardless of the fact that they lost Kingsley Keke, Landis Durham, Dalen Mack. You know, the guys that they're replacing them with, Jaden Peavy, Bobby Brown, obviously Justin Matabike, all those guys performed extremely well. Tyree Johnson looks really good. I think that that's not going to be that big an issue. Linebackers, we're not going to really know until summer. Offensive line, I think, is still a work in progress.
How do you replace Eric McCoy?
You don't. But offensive MVP for the spring was Ryan McCollum, who is going to be the replacement at center. So that's a positive thing if you look at it that way. So, you know, this looks like a good football team, to be perfectly honest. I mean, they need to stay healthy. They need more depth. But they're very competitive. They look like they're strong where they need to be. And honestly, I was very impressed with the true freshman.
That's what I think is that, you know, this team is improving compared to last year. They are improving. But is it enough for this ridiculous schedule that they're about to face?
That's a good question. I don't think that until, really they get out on the field the first weekend against Texas State and really go at an opposing team. Do they have a lot of talent? Yeah, but Kellen Mond has to get better. The offensive line has to improve. You need Jayshon Corbin to be a consistent number one back. Somebody's got to be a backup to him. To Derek Pritchard, good tonight. You need the wideouts to take the next step. One of them to really just break out and be like an A1 guy. And then, you know, just go from there.
You were talking about Kellen Mond. Mond now a junior, his second year in Jimbo's offense, though. But he's also the veteran of the SEC in quarterback-wise. He's, I think, been here the longest in the SEC West.
Right.
His game has improved each year. The ability for him to be able to scramble but then also extend the throw. But are you seeing everything that you need to see tonight? Was his command on top of it? Was his timing? Was his passes crisp?
Well, first pass was terrible. The interception, that was just really, really bad. Then he went on a streak where I think he hit 10 in a row. Then he kind of slacked off a little bit at the end. I don't think Jimbo was very happy with the last drive because he wanted to push the ball down the field and didn't. Overall, I think that he looked better, but could he be even better than that? Yeah, I think he can, and that's what they really are going to need if they're going to get through this death march.
All right, so a lot of more football coming at you this summer, especially than in spring ball. But this weekend, stay tuned because we already have a lot of recruits lined up to talk with us. Malik Carr, Smart Chibuzo, Jalen Jones, Damon DeMoss, and it goes on. So tune back in. Mark Passwaters here with Courtney Rowland for AggieL.com.